To get Daphile started, first locate the Daphile webpage, and from there go to the downloads and get the recommended ISO installation media. That's the more stable one to use. And also while you're there, go and grab the USB writer they recommend. This will be used to burn the ISO to a USB stick. Once you've got it downloaded, navigate to the USB writer zip file and unpack it. Once it's unpacked, start the USB writer, point it to the Daphile ISO you downloaded, and most important, make sure you pick the correct drive file. It'll override anything you point it at. This will take a while to burn the ISO image to the USB stick. Once it's finished, boot your device to its BIOS menu and set it up for booting from a USB stick. Well, that worked. I got into the BIOS by pressing delete. Now I just got to get it to boot from the drive I expected to boot from. I guess I should put the little USB stick I loaded the installer for the Daphile operating system on. I have no idea what it's doing. It would be nice if it told me which one it was doing it, but I think it's a SanDisk Cruiser, so go for it. And that file is loading. Okay, press F1 to perform initial installs. Yes, I want an English keyboard. Yes, I want to trash the drive. When the USB stick boots successfully, it'll give you an IP address on your network. Everything else is done through a web page is going to that IP address. Okay, as you can see, the Daphile is up. It's loading its web pages. And at this point, it is running in memory only. You cannot change any options. You will use an option as interface to actually load it to the disk you cleared. At this point, I'm just going to browse around a few of the menu items to see what's there. Okay, now I've picked a GUID format instead of MS-DOS 5. It's a little less compatible, but But I don't have anything else running on this server, so it should be fine. And I picked the drive that I cleared, and now it's actually loading itself into the... It's actually loading itself onto the internal drive. It still needs to reboot to actually activate the new OS. A little more poking around never hurt to see what options are showing up now. As you can see, there's a ton of options you can change to set it up to work just the way you want it to do work. And storage, I think, is one of the more important options. This is where you tell it where to find your media. Anyway, I'm rebooting because A, you can't change options the way it was, and we're waiting for it to restart now. There it goes. And now it's the version running from the internal drive where you can change options. It does have a lot of features you can select. Anyway, as I said, the settings are the most important at this point. Do we need to set the storage drive? I'm running off a NAS drive. Or rather, a KIFS volume on my network. And it helps to know your mount point name. Which in my case, the server's called Merlin, and the drive, or the mount point's called audio, and the mount point's called audio. I had a lot of typing here and bad memory, because I did it wrong the first time. We're gonna have to re-verify and go and fix it. We won't mount unless it's spelled right. Oh, and in my case, it's case sensitive. The super secret password, and you have to give it a mount point name. I'll just call it after the server it's serving it. And it's mounted. And now I'll change a few more options that I wanted to set. Time zone is quite useful to have your own time zone set, or all the files will be showing up with odd time signatures. And I also want to set CD ripping to be a WAV file, so I'm successful at picking all the wrong headings. There it is. When I rip, I want to save the WAV, not the FLAC. After all, high drive space is relatively inexpensive nowadays. And it reboots again.